Good morning. Let us begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our gospel reading, according to St. Luke, is all about discipleship accepted or rejected. Jesus tells his disciples, I tell you, everyone who acknowledges me before others, the Son of Man will acknowledge before the angels of God. St. Paul, in writing to the Romans, says, How beautiful are the feet of those who bring the good news. This is discipleship at its best. Bringing the love of Christ to others and spreading the good news of salvation through Christ Jesus is what discipleship is all about. We do this for the love of Christ. We do this for the love of neighbor. But we can also walk away from discipleship and even deny Jesus. The results of this are eternally devastating. Yet Jesus tells the disciples that everyone who speaks a word against the Son of Man will be forgiven. God's mercy endures forever. No sin is greater than His mercy, which means He can and will forgive anything. Secondly, because God is love, there never was nor will there ever be someone whom God doesn't love unconditionally. So the big question looms over us. But the one who blasphemes against the Holy Spirit will not be forgiven. What does this mean? Does it mean there is an unforgivable sin? No, emphatically no. When God forgives, it is through the power of the Holy Spirit. It is the advocate sent to us that pours God's mercy into our hearts. So when the priest says the prayer of absolution in the confessional, he says, God the Father of mercies, through the death and resurrection of his Son, has reconciled the world to himself and sent the Holy Spirit among us for the forgiveness of sins. This prayer expresses the vital role the Holy Spirit plays in our experience of God's mercy. St. Paul wrote, The love of God has been poured out into our hearts through the Holy Spirit. And elsewhere we read that the Holy Spirit is our divine advocate who offers healing to our guilty consciences. So to blaspheme against the Holy Spirit is to deny him the chance to minister God's mercy. God wants to forgive, always and in all conditions. Are we ready to ask for forgiveness, be repentant, and resolved to try and not sin again? Amen.